Tiki Falls is officially closed. Officially closed.
These guys are just on fire. Start blazing those colors.
Trust me, I know my Ohana.
It's official, guys. Do, 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 do. Baby koi. They all stay in their own lane.
I'm not a weirdo. Aloha, my Ohana. It is your boy back in it to win it. Now, if you're new to the channel, let me be the first to give you a nice big warm aloha. Welcome. On this channel, we talk about everything aquatics, whether it be aquarium, saltwater, freshwater, big, huge koi ponds, DIY projects in the aquarium hobby, and local fish store tours. All right, before we jump into this video, Ohana, I wanna give a huge shout out to Island Silver Crowns. If you're new to the channel, you may be saying, what's Island Silver Crowns? Right here, what I'm wearing on my dome. This is a crown right here, an Island Silver Crown. Now, a lot of you guys call them hats, but there they call them crowns, and there's a reason, because when you get yourself a crown and you put it on, you feel like royalty. Yeah, they have the most unique crowns. You gotta check them out. Check out their website. All of their links would be down in the description below. But not only that though, right, there's their Instagram. Go follow them on Instagram and check out all the pics on Instagram. They make custom crowns too as well, and they have an entire sports line. Speaking of sports line, I should be getting something in the mail soon, so stay tuned to see what crown your boy got next. Anyways, I just wanted to spread that aloha spirit to my boy, Brother Kanoa from Island Silver Crowns. Go cop yourself a crown and help a family business out. Really appreciate you, Ohana, and I really appreciate you guys following and supporting Island Silver Crowns. Now, if you look over my shoulder, this is my predator tank where I have my Oscillaris peacock bass and my two beautiful Oscars. One is a long fin Oscar named Big, and the other one is a smaller albino tiger Oscar too. So let's go check them out. I get a lot of comments asking, hey, how are they doing? Has the Oscillaris peacock bass started to attack any of the Oscars? So we'll do a quick update, all right? Check it out.
And here they are, Ohana. As you can see, Big is doing great. My long fin tiger Oscar, along with Lamon, who just irritates him all day, right here. My albino tiger Oscar. I swear, these two are inseparable. They might be pairing up. I think that Lamon is a male, and I think Big is a female. Big is crazy. Big will just do nose dives and scoop up sand, but this dude here just does not leave his or her side. So I got my eyes on them. And then of course we have Zeus, my Oscillaris peacock bass, who is doing great. Those of you that are like always asking, hey, you know what's going on? Is your peacock bass picking on the Oscars? Not at all. They live like in peace and harmony, I swear. It's the coolest thing. They all stay in their own lane. I don't see any aggression. They just kind of do their thing and just eat and just grow. As you can see, Zeus is getting big. As far as the SDC Extreme pump goes, right there, the propeller pump by SICCE, it is doing great, moving water, water agitation, sorry for the glare, all the way across. But not only that though, look at the substrate in the back. Remember all that detritus I had, remnants down at the bottom? Oh, it's clean. Look at it, so clean. I do wanna get one more and put one on this side of the aquarium, then maybe face it down just to get everything, because there's a little bit back there. There's some dead spots, but man, not as bad as it was. So it's keeping this 120 gallon aquarium. This is 4 feet by 2 feet high, 2 feet from front to back, okay? This aquarium, clean. Just that one little pump right there. Oh, I'm telling you guys, go check them out. Go get one. You guys won't be disappointed when it comes to that pump. But anyways, everyone in here is doing great, guys. Just a quick little update for you.
All right, my Ohana. So I don't know if you guys remember this, but about 7 months ago, I was at Geyser Pets, one of my local fish stores, and the manager there, Jeff, gifted me with a birthday fish. It was a red tiger severum. I'll actually put a picture of him right there when I actually got him. You see him, what he looks like? Well, I wanted to do a quick update. He's in this aquarium right here, my South American-ish aquarium. And I wanted to give you guys an update on his colors, on what he looks like. Now, the severums are, I don't know, I wanna say semi-slow growing, especially when it comes to showing colors, but wait till you see the colors this guy has. Now, if you guys follow me on Instagram, you might've seen some pictures, because I do post a lot of, I guess you can say, sneak peeks on my Instagram account before I actually make a video on YouTube. So if you haven't followed me, Hawaiian Fish Keeper, on Instagram, why don't you give your boy a follow and get some sneak peeks and be ahead of the game. And it's absolutely free. Anyways, let's go check out the red tiger severum.
Look at him now, my Ohana. What a beauty. You see the colors coming in, the stripes are coming in. How about the red right on his neck? And he's got a little bit of bluish coming in too on his finnage. Oh, he's so beautiful. I wanted to give you guys a quick update on this beautiful red tiger Severum. He's coming in nice though. Man, I can't wait for him to just start blazing those colors.
Now that I showed you guys the red tiger Severum, we're gonna go outside and I'm gonna actually break some bad news to you guys. I don't mean to be a downer at this point of the video, but somebody's gotta do it, right? And it's not so much bad news for you guys as much as it is for me. Let's go outside where the above ground pond is and Tiki Falls is, all right? Let's go. Boom, just like that, we are outside. You can never go wrong with YouTube teleportation. I'm telling you, it is the best. Behind me, the above ground pond, you can see all my koi, my goldfish, doing great. Love this pond, have nothing but great things to say about this pond. You see it all the time on social media, Instagram, Facebook page. Love this above ground pond. Now, this is a staging area. If you guys are new to my channel, this is a staging area for these babies because we are redoing my below ground pond, Tiki Falls, which is right over here. We're gonna turn the camera and I'm gonna show you what Tiki Falls looks like right now. This is the bad news, or should I say the sad news, all right? Look it, it is officially closed. Tiki Falls is officially closed. Let me turn the camera around so you guys get a better view at this.
It's official, guys, like a referee with a whistle. I actually took the pump out. You can see the aquascape biofalls. 1,000 is actually nothing. There's nothing in it except some water. Let me show you. I actually took the sponges out, rinsed everything out. The media I actually took out of it too as well. We stuck it in the above ground pond, but yeah, I'm gonna get the rest of this rock out of this because I'm not going to waste it. This pond pebble here is super expensive, so we're gonna go ahead and get the rest of that rock picked up as much as we can, rip this liner out, and remove the perforated pipe, as you can see it on this side going through. Sorry it's wet out here. It rained, actually. It's gonna be raining for the next week here. Still gotta remove all these rocks here too as well, along with these rocks that have some waterfall foam. Same thing with those rocks there. So, quick little update. Tiki Falls is officially closed. Officially closed. Whew, big changes. If you guys are new to the channel, if you guys see this red marking here, that's gonna be the start of my new waterfall. And as you pan out here, you see that red line that goes way out over there and comes back down through here. You see this red line? That's gonna be all pond. You can see the red line right here. Yeah, so this pond is gonna be massive. So if I walk this way, you can kind of get a bird's eye view of how big my pond's going to be, which is going to be Tiki Falls 4.0. So if you haven't subscribed to this channel, hit that subscribe button and turn on that notification bell. All you have to do is click it, turn it on. It's going to notify you when I upload a new video. You don't want to miss any videos on the rebirth of Tiki Falls 4.0, trust me, okay? And then you're part of the Ohana too. Everybody wants to be a part of the Ohana. It's like the in thing right now. Speaking of in thing, remember in my earlier videos when I used to say, hey guys, I was checking out YouTube's analytics and it was telling me that more than half of you guys that watch my videos are not even subscribed? Hit that subscribe button. You remember that whole little saying? Well, I was looking through the analytics. I don't know if you guys remember, but before it used to be like at 12 to 17% of you guys that were watching my videos were subscribed. Now check out the percentage. That's so awesome. It's at 45%. I'm like, what? But, 5% more. Let's try to get half, all right? I'm okay with half. 50%, that would be awesome, guys. So, do me a favor, guys, and hit that subscribe button if you're loving the content, which you are. Trust me, I'm reading your mind. Now, before you guys tend to get a little buck wild, Ohana, trust me, I know my Ohana. I'm gonna answer the $1 million question. Over here in Tiki Falls, I did have three baby koi. Did have four, but lost one. So now we're down to 3 baby koi, and I figured, you know what? It's time to get them out of there and just put them in here with the rest of the crew. I didn't want to lose any more koi. Not only that though, baby koi need the water a little bit more warmer because they don't have enough fat on their bodies because they're babies. So I figured, you know what? I'm gonna put them in the above ground pond where it's insulated. I could somewhat monitor the temperature here in the above ground pond because of my SICCE Synchra SDC 6.0, shameless plug. Anyways, I put them in here, guys, along with the orange comet goldfish that we rescued here locally too as well. So all 4 fish in the above ground pond. Let's check them out. I mean, look at the kids right now. They are on fire. Anyways, here is one baby koi right here. Doot, 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 baby koi. There he goes. He's going in the little tunnel there, but he's doing good. Here's another baby koi right here with the little orange nose. He is doing great too. They're loving it. They immediately started a school with everybody else, which I think they needed that, you know? There he is. He's really hard to find because he's kind of just a regular plain Jane type of color. Kind of a dark gray with a little tint. I don't even want to say blue, but he's just got a weird gray tint to him, a little bit of silver on him. And look at this little baby butterfly koi. You remember this guy I picked up at PetSmart? This is the only PetSmart koi I've ever bought in my life. That's him. Yeah, so we're gonna see how he grows. Oh, and then here is that orange comet goldfish that we rescued right there. So they're all doing great. Good times in here, guys. Good times, but look at the colors. These guys are just on fire. And know what? I'm standing completely over the pond. So you can tell these guys are so used to me now. Remember how skittish they used to be? Running under rocks and caves and hiding from me. Now they're just like, feed us, Papa. Papa, feed us.
All right, my Ohana. So I actually threw some food in there for the kids. Make them happy, you know. And we're going to get into this video. Now, this video is sort of like part 2 of my last video where I was over at Aquarium Depot. Did a store tour there. Haven't been there in a while. Go check it out if you haven't seen it. I'll put a card up above. You guys will absolutely love it. That place is so bomb, I'm telling you right now. Anyways, now in that video, towards the end of it, I said I did pick something up. But you guys are going to have to wait till the next video. And by gosh, right now is the next video. So let's go see what I picked up. But before I do, there's an employee there named Tom Lowe. Tom Lowe, I'm gonna give you a big shout out. He actually left this comment right here. You see that comment? He said that there was a baby gulper catfish that was there at Aquarium Depot that I was like totally jonesing on, which means loving. And he said, after I did that video, that gulper catfish was gone. So he's claiming that that's the fish that I picked up. So Tom, this one's for you. Let's go see what your boy picked up. Let's go. Oh, snap, Ohana, I have some groundbreaking news. Man, I forgot about this. I don't even know how I forgot about it. It's actually right here. As I was walking in the house, I was like, oh, I forgot to share this with the Ohana. I am gonna do a video on it, more specific in detail about it, but I don't know, maybe I'll just give you a sneak peek on this video here. Oh man, I'm super excited. Not only did I pick up a new fish, but I also picked up some items that I kind of talked about over at Aquarium Depot when I was there. Now, if you're paying attention, you might have read between the lines. And if you guys are smart, which the Ohana is, you guys probably know what I'm about to tell you guys. Yeah, game changer, my channel, something new. I'm gonna show it to you though. But before I do, don't worry. I am gonna do the new fish dance. For those of you guys that are new to the channel, you're probably wondering, what is the new fish dance? Don't worry, you guys are gonna love it, okay? The new fish dance is something that I made up. It's that feeling that you get when you buy a new fish as an aquarium hobbyist. So I just express it through song and dance. And some of you guys can relate to that feeling that are fish keepers, and then some of you guys can relate to the dance part too as well. Just so you guys know, I know at home right now you guys are wondering, is that what I think it is? Yes, it is. It's a portrait of a weenie dog with dreadlocks. Yeah, it's kind of our weenie Rastafari. Boop, boop. Here is the aquarium where the new fish is in. Now, you guys may look at this aquarium. I haven't showed it in a while. And you may notice it looks a little different, right? Well, it is. There's some new rock that's added. You know, you got this stone here. I think it's Siri stone. I'm not sure exactly what kind of rock it is. And you can see there's new plants too. You can see Anubias down in here, Nana Petite. Over here you got some red crypts right there planted, some more red crypts planted over there too as well. But anyways, I'm gonna show you the new fish in a second. I just wanted to show you guys this. You remember
this spot right here. Let me refresh your memory. My UNS aquarium, remember the 7-gallon nano tank? Let me show you a picture of it right there. You see it? Yeah, beautiful aquarium, right? Loved it. Had some galaxy Daniels in there. I did have a betta at one time in there. I tore it down. Well, there's nothing wrong with it. Had zero problems with it. But the reason why I broke it down is because something's gonna go here instead. Let me show you guys. One, two, three. Boom! Look at that. Oh, Hana. You are not seeing things. This is a saltwater nano setup. I'm excited to share this with you guys. We will go into a little bit more details on a future video on this setup. Now, I am excited, Ohana, to share this little saltwater journey with you guys. I have never done saltwater, never attempted it. And hopefully on my channel, I can show you guys how easy, I think, I hope, and fun it is. Now, this is a 10-gallon nano aquarium, and I will get into more specs on a future video on this setup. Now, this setup I got from my boy, Dennis. Dennis, thank you, brother. I really appreciate it. That guy spoils me. You know, I'm sort of like his side chick. You know what I mean? He's got his wife, and then I'm like his side chick that he kind of spoils me with aquarium products. So anyways, this was his. So I gave it a good cleaning. I did purchase some upgrades for this aquarium. So stay tuned. No worries. We're going to get into a video on all the details. I just wanted to share this quick little surprise with you guys. We are going to do saltwater on this channel. All right, Ohana, before I hit you guys with the B-roll on the new fish in this aquarium, let me just brief you guys a little bit on the stock in here, because I haven't done an update on this aquarium in quite some time. So I also have an electric blue Jack Dempsey, which you will see in the B-roll. I'm just reminding you, okay? Then we also have my red spotted gold Severum. And then we have my albino bristlenose pleco. They're all juvenile, so they're super small. And then we have the new fish. So in the B-roll, I will show you guys the fish that were in here, and then I'll show you guys the brand new fish. But before we do, I gotta hit you guys with the new fish dance, right? So, cue the music! What? I'm doing the new fish dance. Don't interrupt me when I'm doing the new fish dance. The missus, she thinks I'm a weirdo. She's like, what are you doing? I go, the new fish dance. She goes, God, you're weird. Guys, down below in the comments, let's just show the missus, okay? If you guys really do love the fish dance, or should I just get rid of the new fish dance? You guys, down below, comment, yes, fish dance, no, fish dance, okay? I don't think she knows what she's talking about. The Ohana loves it, babe, just giving you a heads up. I'm not a weirdo. They love it. Right? You guys love it, right? Anyways, let's hit the B-roll.
Lightning strikes by my window. It's my chest right in the morning. Like a warning. Could have slept here for days.
That's right, my Ohana, we got a Geophagus. This is a fish that I've always wanted to keep. Aquarium Depot only had one in the aquarium, but it's okay. Now, I don't know if you noticed that his tail was a little chewed up, nipped on, but it's okay. Your boy's gonna get him better. When this guy gets older, though, he's gonna be a stunner. He already has so much promise. Like, you can see the colors, the greens, the reds, and when he is full grown, this is what he's gonna look like. See that? Whew, he's gonna be gorgeous. Now, there are a bunch of different species of Geophagus. Now, this one here is a Geophagus serenamensis. This one here is going to get a little bit larger than the norm, all right? These guys tip off at about 10 inches, sometimes even 12 inches. So they're on the bigger side of the Geos. Now, they also have such cool names. They go by Geos, they go by Earth Eaters because of the name Geo. Phagus, geo meaning earth, phagus meaning eat or eater. So there you go, earth eater. And the reason being is they clean the entire tank. They will sift through the sand, especially the sand substrate, and you can see it goes through their mouth, filters out their gills, and they're looking for small particles of food. So they're constantly sifting through the whole entire aquarium, especially if you have a sand bottom. So hey, keep that in mind. These guys are cleaners and they look clean too with the color once they get full grown. So I am just super excited. These fish are gonna be awesome. And let's not forget about the saltwater tank. Stay tuned for an up and coming video where we go into a little bit more detail about the saltwater setup. I'm excited. I'm nervous, but I'm also excited to venture and just dip my toe in the realm of salt water. So with that being said, I will see you guys on the next video. Hope you guys enjoyed it. Much love and aloha. Oh.